Hey everyone, this is Dave from the Adobe Character Animator team, and today I wanted to show you a preview of a new feature that we're working on behind the scenes in Character Animator. And we'd love to get your feedback on this. So if you're interested in trying this out today in our beta program, stay tuned to the end of the video and I'll show you exactly how to do it. But let's get into the feature right now and showing you what it's all about in its current state. So I've got this simple robot character that I made in Adobe Illustrator and brought into Character Animator, and it's got the head tracking, it's got some antenna physics up here. I can drag the arms around, and the arms I've added the arm IK behavior to. So arm inverse kinematics, this is a behavior that we added a few years back, which will determine how the elbows bend when you move your arm. So at a certain point, that elbow is gonna pop the other way, and you have complete control over where that happens. It also prevents some stretching in the arms and some other things to make it look a little bit more realistic. Well, up until this point, that IK behavior has only been limited to the arms. But check out what happens when I move my head down a little bit now with this character. Notice that the knees are starting to bend realistically as well. And so we have now changed the arm IK behavior into the limb IK behavior. And if I twirl this open, you'll see now I have the ability to do not just arms, but also arms and legs. So just like I can drag the arms around and have the elbows bend realistically, I can drag the feet around and also have the knees bend as I would expect as well. So you've got a few options over here. So let's say I've got my knees bent like this, but my character's view is facing the other way, or their proportions are a little bit different and I feel like the knees should be bending the opposite way. No problem. Just go to reverse leg bend left or right and check those, and then your character will change how their stance, what's their kind of default leg movement there. You have a few other options like ground detection and initial foot panning. If I turned both of these off, then my character is just gonna kind of float in the air. There's no sense of ground. But what happens if I check both of these is that whatever your initial foot position is when your character first comes into the scene, that's gonna be considered the ground. And we can use that to do some pretty cool stuff, right? So if I wanted my character to jump, I can kind of drag down here. I'm dragging the character and then jump up and then back down, and it's gonna remember where that ground area is. So it's never been easier to, you know, have a character sitting down or jumping up or all of that sort of stuff is a lot easier now with this functionality. Now, if you want even more custom control about how all of your different draggable handles are working, you can actually open up this little pin area down here. And so right now, like left wrist is set to puppet. Left and right wrist are both set to puppet. So that means when I move my puppet around, you know, when I move my head around and all of that, the wrists are gonna basically be moving around with the puppet movement at the same time. But look what happens when I set this to behavior instead. So let's go ahead and do that. And now look what happens. Let's say I had my arms like up like this, and now I drag my puppet. The arms are going to try to stay in place. So it's like he's like peering over the top of a fence or something like that, or doing pull-ups. They're gonna try to stay in one place. And even if I move my puppet around, those hands are going to stay more or less where they should be. So there's a lot of cool stuff. Like if I'm getting into a tug of war over here, let's move the arms like this, and then we'll pull and go back and pull. And basically they will try to stay in the same place until they reach a breaking point where it would break the IK, and then they'll kind of follow the character a little bit more and go back. So this has a lot of, you know, cool options. If I want to get up from a desk, for example, I'm sitting down and then I'm like, okay, I'm going to get up and put my hands on the desk or something like that, or vault over something. So the rigging process for this is pretty simple. So if I've got a character in rig mode, I can just go up to here next to the name, click the plus button and go ahead and click limb IK. And that's going to add the behavior to the entire puppet. And then just like I would have rigged the arms with, you know, shoulder, elbow, and a wrist, and added the draggable handle in the wrist, the exact same thing is true of the legs. So let's zoom in a little bit and take a closer look at this leg. So I've got my hip, I've dragged the origin of the middle, basically this little dotted line circle of where this should pivot from for the leg, which is definitely, you want it up pivoting from the hips up here. And I'm gonna tag that origin as a hip. I've got my knee, I've got an ankle, I've got the heel, which is where we recommend also adding the draggable handle, and then the toe. And I added some extra sticks here just to add a little bit more rigidity into some of the bone structure, but you can try different experiments and see what works best for your character. And I did the exact same thing for the left leg as well. And this can be applied to characters both old and new alike. So here's the old version of Chloe. I'm moving her head, I'm moving around, and notice the legs really aren't doing much of anything. There's no knee bend, there's nothing happening at all. But if I make her legs independent and tag everything the correct way and add limb IK, now she has a little bit of bend to her. I can make her jump up like that, drag her legs to, you know, do a ninja pose or dance or whatever I want all over the place and do some yoga or workout exercises or something like that. So again, Limb IK is not in the current shipping version of Character Animator, but it is in our beta pre-release program. And if you're interested in joining and trying this on your characters right now and giving us your feedback, just go up to your Creative Cloud desktop icon and you'll notice there's this section called Beta Apps. And this is gonna give you access to beta versions of a bunch of different Creative Cloud apps. And so you can try a bunch of these and see new features before they're done. For example, I've been using a lot of the new Rotobrush 2 tool in After Effects that has recently been announced that is just incredibly fast and amazing. So if you're interested, if there's programs you're using all the time and want to see some of the latest, greatest features they're using, I highly recommend installing some stuff from this page. And at this point, we're just looking for feedback. This is a, you know, first attempt at putting this out there, but we know there's a lot of things we want to fix and change and make better before we release it to a mainstream wider audience. And that's where you come in and all your different character types and body types and, you know, characters with 27 limbs coming out. I don't know what kind of character that is, but I'm sure someone out there is going to make it. And we would love to hear your feedback on what's working, what isn't working, and how we can improve it. What's kind of blocking us from being able to ship this? That's really important to us. So if you'd like to give your feedback, when you download the beta version, you're gonna get these little icons in the upper right corner. And if you click this little conversation icon and go to visit the community, that's gonna take you to our official beta forums where you can comment and discuss any features or thoughts that you're running into. So for example, if I have feedback about Limb IK, I can add it to this thread, feature focus Limb IK. I've got another video here that shows you a little bit more about it, as well as some example files down here. And I'm gonna include the robot down here as well for you to check out as well. And then you can add your comments and feedback below. So hopefully that's a pretty cool taste of things to come. I think as we continue evolving, you know, I think in the very early days of Character Animator was basically head animator, right? You just had a talking head that moves around. And now as we've slowly added things like the walk behavior, arm IK, limb IK, other things like that, keyframes, replays, you're starting to see that it really is the full character animation package. And we're just gonna keep moving down this path and making your characters more and more expressive. So hopefully this is a step in the right direction and we would love to hear what you think about it. So please download the beta, give us your feedback, try it on your puppets. And until next time, thanks for watching and have fun.